Thank you to watch my presentation. My name is Lau Kin On. I want to make a presentation on how to prepare water with high electron density. So my title of presentation is the generation of electrons in water using the principle of induced current. I have a PhD from the University of Manchester, UK. Presently, I am the Managing Director of IOP Specialist Sdn Bhd in Malaysia. And my company has 10 patents granted worldwide, and I am the inventor. The principle of induced current is very simple. Consider we have any object, that means all objects. When this object is moving, and the moving is forced by a force. When the object forced to move into a magnetic field, electron will be generated. And this is the principle of induced current. So we give an example in the real life. And this example is a cloud lightning. So the cloud will move in the atmosphere, it will move, and during the raining time, the cloud has lightning. So the electron that contained in the cloud is actually come from the principle of induced current. So in this case, cloud is moving, and the magnetic field is the Earth's magnetic field. So therefore, in certain condition, cloud can do lightning. So in our experiment, we prepare the magnetic materials into the container. So, and then we have a plastic tube so that water can flow in and flow out from the container. So the principle of induced current in this case is that so water is moving into the magnetic field. And the magnetite powder is the source of the magnetic field. So what in the water, electron is created because of the principle of induced current. So consider that the water can dissociate according to the ionization process. So when water is dissociated, ion of hydrogen and ion of hydroxyl will be the product. However, when the water moves into the magnetic field, electron will be created. And this electron is a negatively charged particle. Negatively charged particle will then be attracted to the positive particle, which is in this case is the hydrogen ion. Hence, the hydrogen electron pairs form in this matter. So once the hydrogen electron pair is formed, so the concentration of the ion hydrogen in the water ionization equilibrium process reduces, and the ion of hydroxyl increases. So when the ion of hydroxyl increase, the pH of the water will be increased. And this is the principle of Li criteria. So how we perform the experiment is that, so we have a source water, and this source water has a pH value. So I consider this as a lower pH value. So the source water will be pumped using a peristaltic pump and pumped through the magnetic treatment device. So after this, water will treated in the magnetic field and will be collected in as a product water. So we use two kinds of source water for the experiments. One is the distilled water, another one which is the tap water. So the result is that when the water of the distilled water flow through the magnetic field, The initial pH was 5.65 and when the water leaving after the magnetic field, pH immediately increased to 5.94. So this is a great finding where electrons were generated and the pH were increased. Similarly, when we record the resistivity of the water, so the water before flowing into the container, which is higher, 185 kiloohm. But after leaving the container, because of the electron generated in the water, it become lower, which is 133 kiloohm. So when I repeat the tap water, so the tap water I take from different sources and I use four sources here. So source one, the pH increment recorded was 0.25. However, when I use source 2, the pH increment was 0.53. Source 3, increment was 0.46. And source 4, increment was 0.38. So when we look at the results, the pH increment was not a constant. Such phenomenon was because of the water contain different contaminations. Such contaminations will affect the final results of the pH. However, all the sources show pH were increased, and this shows that electrons were generated in the water. So in conclusion, I can make the pH of distilled water or the pH of tap water all increase. And the resistivity of distilled water and the resistivity of tap water all decrease. This shows electrons were generated in the water and captured in the water as the hydrogen electron pairs. So what is the future work I can do about this is that I can perform more chemical and physical analysis of the electron water. So as a result of the hydrogen electron pairs were formed, perhaps there may be some chemical changes or some physical changes of the water. I need to perform more experiments. So I can also have different sorts of magnetic materials, not just magnetite powder. In this method, I can also use permanent magnet or other soft magnetic materials other than iron oxide. I can also need to know if I have other kinds of source water, whether or not electron can be generated and absorbed in the water. And in this method, for example, can use filter water. So these are the future work I plan to do. So what is the benefit of doing this project is that, so the benefit can be in the drinking water industries. The benefit also can be in the medication field. So my other experiment shows also the water, apart from creating the electron, it will also produce oxygen. And this oxygen has different properties. And perhaps this oxygen is good for COVID-19 patients, but these are all still pending further investigation. And this project also good for the pharmaceutical industry, combustion technology, agricultural industry, and so on. So the detail will not be discussed here, but pending further investigation. Thank you to watch my presentation.